Let's go!
Against the beanpole from Brazil, Edson Marquez. Let's see if Marquez can get those hands working early. The jab to cross, the hooks he's known for. Will Tatsuka try to get on the inside, pick him up and slam him down?
Yeah, Michael, the key to Marquez here is going to be that jab. He's got to utilize it to set up everything else and also just kind of disrupt the rhythm of Tetsuka. He's got to try to use the jab to avoid the takedown and also the footwork as well. He's got a wide stance, so he's got to be careful with that because the distance and the footwork might be to his detriment.
Trying to thread a jab of his own there, did the Japanese beast. Don't forget you can play the Rod Tongue and Victoria League games now on the One Super app. Download it now. Outside leg kick there from Tetsuka. Jab, fake outside leg kick. Nice there, Dragon.
That's one thing with that wide stance, though, is he's going to start to chew up that lead leg of Marquez.
You know what we always say, the best way to stop a boxer is to kick his legs, because once you take out the legs, they can't box effectively.
Especially if he starts going after that low leg. If he starts to kick on those calves of Marquez, Tetsuka could find some openings. But just as I say that, Marquez does it.
Foot inside leg kick there from Edson Marquez. On the outside, Tetsuka showing patience early on. Loops in the left hand, didn't connect, and Marquez drifts towards center circle.
Yeah, that was good footwork by Marquez to not get trapped up against the wall. He needs to stay on his bicycle, keep moving, keep touching, keep moving.
Ooh, Tetsuka went for the headache maker, but Marquez saw it coming. In boxing range, tries up the jab, gets taken down by the Japanese beast.
Yeah, relatively easy takedown by Tetsuka as he lands in side control here. He's got the underhook on the left side, so that's good.
Let's go, improve your position.
That massive upper body is just going to try to keep Marquez flat on his back.
Tetsuka inside control, little shoulder thrust there. What are the options here for the Japanese beast, Mitch?
Well, he's going to probably soften him up a little bit. He says that his BJJ is going to be the difference in this matchup. He doesn't think that Marquez really has the grappling ability to keep up with him on the ground, so he really wants to press this action here. Now that he's got an advantageous position, he needs to utilize it. Good job by Marquez to retain half guard. He slid his knee in there and was able to slide in and capture one of the legs of Tetsuka.
Staying busy. While you see Marquez controlling Tetsuka's posture, not allowing him to posture up and really rain down with the ground and pound, and Tetsuka just keeps moving that right hand, not doing any damage, but just staying busy.
Well, he hit him like 25 times there, so it might be a little damage after a while. Not a lot, hard to get the leverage that you need to really do any damage with the ground and pound right there, but it caused Marquez to let go of the head as he grabs on his head again.
Player edging towards that Apprentice One Championship Edition logo on the canvas. That kicks off in over 150 countries on Netflix this Tuesday, February 1st. Check your local TV guides. It is awesome.
The Apprentice Rich, you gotta improve One your Championship position, Edition.
Man. And again, Tetsuka, the Japanese beast, just staying busy off that right glove.
Yeah, Marquez is just kind of holding on to the head, really hoping for a stand-up from referee Mohamed Sulaiman. But I think because of the activity of Tetsuka, it's going to be hard for referee to stand them up. So as long as Tetsuka can stay active here and just keep doing a little bit of work with the ground and pound and not really stall out, he's going to be able to maintain this position. I wouldn't mind seeing him slide out of this position and try to advance as Marquez tries to pop back up, but good top control, float over.
Look at the angles that Tetsuka's working. That right hand still. Can he wrench into the canvas from here? Belly to back at the moment. Knee to the hamstring area. Spinning back elbow attempt there from Marquez. How does Marquez get out of this predicament, Mitch?
Well, then he's just doing it, right? Okay. Yeah, dug his hand right in, spun around, created that separation. You have to break those grips.
Now, this is the range Marquez wants. There's the overhand right to the left hook. Jumping knee was a little sloppy, though, from the Brazilian.
But he followed up with a nice little hook as Tetsuka was able to circle out.
Jab, no right hand for company, though, from Marquez. Shoots the jab out again.
But Tetsuka did a good job of slipping that as well. I think he's understanding the range at which Marquez is starting to fire as he tries to close it immediately with hands.
Into the body with a liver shot. End of the round, we go to the towels. Impressive start from Hiroyuki Tetsuka. And Marquez has got to try and keep it standing at the start of the second.
Yeah, this is really where Tetsuka was able to do good work. He was able to get into a dominant position, do a little bit of work with the ground and pound, nothing significant until he got the back. A lot of these shots missed and connect. You could see him trying to go around the arm, underneath the armpit. But nothing really too big. Marquez was able to work his way back up to his feet, so that's going to help him with confidence.
Looking very relaxed in the corner is Tetsuka. Not so, though, I want to say it to Marquez. He looks a little concerned, Dragon. He's got to keep it standing. As we've said, he's got to sit behind the jab and use it to set up the power salvo off the right.
Yeah, he's got to keep the feet moving. He's got to utilize the jab. He's got to stay on his bicycle and also circle away from that power side of Tetsuka. Tetsuka, I'd like to see him get that takedown again. Immediately crowd him, pack him up against the wall, put him on his back, beat him up, look for a submission.
6th minute of a scheduled 15-minute match. Inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium, you're watching One Championship, only the brave.
Marquez is utilizing that jab, though. He is touching him. There's the right hand for company like you were talking about.
Tetsuka on the balls of his feet. Marquez towers over him. Jab, full extension. Like to see some leg kicks come underneath and maybe not go to the body with the kicks. We saw the kick get caught in the first round by Tetsuka when he went to the ribs, Marquez. Tetsuka trying to get him down.
But that time he had the hooks, so he was able to dig that underhook on that far side and actually prevent Tetsuka from getting in deep on those legs. That was good work by Marquez. He needs to utilize that jab and keep that takedown defense sharp.
Are you sensing the confidence starting to build now on Edson?
I think it's building as he hits him with those jabs. As he's touching him, and then another takedown, if he's able to stop another one, he's going to start to feel it. So this next takedown is going to be very important.
He felt that one, Dragon. Felt it on the lower lumbar region as he went to his back. Closes the guard now in a familiar position we were in for a lot of the first round. If Tetsuka could get that right arm out and start to pop it away to the jaw and the body and just stay busy.
Yeah, that was a good time takedown right there. Off of the leg kick, was able to charge in, put Marquez on his back. I'd expect Marquez to really start to utilize that length.
No holding,
blue.
He's trying
to stay active with his guard. He's trying to inch his guard up a little bit higher.
Watch for the
back of the
head.
That's usually a sign of them starting to look for triangles, especially when they get control of the arm.
Has he got it in his arsenal, though, the submissions?
He's Brazilian, man.
Doesn't automatically qualify him.
He's
for
surrounded
submission.
By the best grapplers in the world. Of course he knows a triangle. Of course. Watch him do it. Look at him, trying to create a little bit of space, trying to frame off. But again, his specialty, Michael, to your point, is the hands. It is going to be that boxing area.
One more time. No back of the head, Red.
He's got to be a little bit active. I like how he opened up his guard.
Second warning there from referee Mohamed Sulaiman. Close guard now for Marquez. Body head goes Tetsuka as he was for much of the first round. Looks to rake the elbow across the bridge of the nose. Locking down that right arm is Marquez. That's the one that the Japanese beast popped in with continually in the first 5 minutes. What's Tetsuka looking to do here, Dragon?
Well, I think he was trying for a head and arm there. I think he stepped over almost fully into half guard now. So once you plant that arm underneath your head underneath their arm, you can start to look for arm triangles. But he's really got to advance his position. I think Tetsuka likes the half guard position because it gives him this control. He can really try to flatten out Marquez and utilize a lot of ground and pound. Even though Marquez is just holding onto his head like this, he's still able to do a little bit of damage with the ground and pound. Just staying active enough not to force a stand-up.
Marquez, who lost his debut to the highly rated Raymond Magomedaliev, Said he was brand new on the global stage, didn't know what to expect. Now that he knows what it's all about and the processes of being in the biggest game of all, he's ready to take on a fight like this on short notice. Once again, he is replacing former world champion Sebastian Canestar.
And it is a match that Tetsuka would like to get back. He still plans on competing against the Swede, but here he's got the Brazilian in front of him, at least on his back, looking for that big ground and pound, but he can't quite. It looks like he doesn't want to create that space, right? Like, you're not seeing him pop up and land big ground and pound. He's keeping chest to chest and just kind of staying in this half guard position because he's able to control him and just soften him up a little bit with the ground and pound.
Looking for the elbow off the right arm there as Tetsuka. 30 seconds remains in this second of three. Still inside half guard, working off the left glove now.
See, I would think that he could possibly advance his position here. If he could take that left leg, slide the knee out, and advance, he could possibly get into side control or mount. Looks exactly what he did right there. He waited for the right time, found the opening, and Marquez is able to get on top and throw a hand.
Can Marquez launch something in the final seconds of this round? He tries to catch him with the right uppercut. Five more minutes remain as we go to the towels. Folks, don't forget, plenty more action coming your way tonight. Up next, it's a heavyweight super series kickboxing contest. Opacic versus Shaya.
See, another beautiful catch off the low kick, right? And see, that's what Marquez needs to stay with the jab. He needs to utilize the jab, kind of abandon the kicks, because that's the second time that Tetsuka has been able to put him on his back with that leg kick.
Second round. There's no decisive damage. Go pounding.
You can see just how dominant Tetsuka is once he's in half guard. And then he tried to advance and try to pass into side control, and that was the opening that Marquez needed to get back up to his feet. I'd expect Tetsuka to get the takedown.
Let's go!
And then look to stay in that half guard unless Marquez can keep it on the feet.
All right, that's the call from the Dragon, Mitch Chilson. Here we go, third round, and Tetsuka opens it up with a leg kick followed by a sliding jab. Marquez needs to stay vertical, needs to use the jab and the cross and the hooks. Tetsuka edges on the inside, drops a lead down to the bread basket. There's a nice right hand that backs off the beast. Need more of that, though, from Edson Marquez.
Yeah, he needs to keep that jab out there. Just keep touching, keep scoring. Marquez is still in this. The match is not so far out in front of him that he can't quite get it back. But he's got to do damage. He's got to take some risks right now. I like the leg kick that Tetsuka threw in the beginning of this round. I'd like to see him just keep going back to it, especially as Marquez circles to his right. See, right there.
Oh, he got caught! Good night, Irene! The Japanese beast with a beastly knockout of Edson Marquez.
The beast out of nowhere gets another late minute KO finish.
Mitch, I did not see that coming.
Neither did I! Out of nowhere, he timed that perfectly, Michael.
I love you. I love you, everyone. Thank you, Japan.
Who am I sort of speechless here?
Thank
because
you.
I did not expect that at all. I thought he'd go to the ground once again.
Beautiful, look at this.
But that is a perfectly placed left hook.
He dips, look at that, dips, boom, comes right up top, throws the hook, touches him right on the button and puts Marquez out.
And knocks out the boxer, with a punch. A beautiful punch.
Sugoi dane.
Good refereeing there from Mohamed Suleiman to save Marquez from that hammer fist that was coming. And there's the acrobatic celebration. Here's Dom.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Mohamed Suleiman, has called a stop to this contest after 1 minute and 5 seconds in the final round for your winner by way of knockout, Hiroyuki